Hello guys, so this is the Chessmaster 11 Grandmaster Edition game, and currently I am playing with Risha, who is 1218 Elo chess personality in the Chessmaster 11 Grandmaster Edition game. And now I am trying a little bit a different kind of opening. Now I am trying to play some kind of closed opening. Okay, let's go for the Queen's Gambit declined. This is the Queen's Gambit declined. Okay. So, according to his profile, Risha likes hanging pants. Risha don't like her pants. Okay. So this is the main line of the Queen's Gambit accepted. Queen's Gambit declined. So this is the main line of the Queen's Gambit declined, and I am now thinking of Bishop to G5. The main move here is C takes and D5. C takes on D5, C takes, then Bishop G5. Okay, let's go for this. Takes. So Black's main move here is retake with the E-pawn. So this is the main move here. And then I go for Bishop to G5. This is the main line of the exchange variation of the Queen's Gambit declined. Okay. My opponent is thinking. So the main line here is E takes on D5, then I go to Bishop G5. Bishop G5, Bishop G5, Bishop E7, then I go to Queen to C2, Queen to C2, C6. E3, then I go forward my other knight, and black castles, and somehow this. Okay, so now my opponent is currently thinking a little bit. So guys, if you like my videos, please consider to give us a thumb up and subscribe to my channel. Okay. Yeah. No, so my opponent decides to take with knight, and okay, this allows me, so of course, because he takes with the knight, this bishop g5 move is impossible because the black queen protects this square. So okay, so if he goes this, if he goes this line, then I attack your knight. Then I attack your knight. Okay. So now I'm expecting that he will take my knight on c3. Then I retake on c3 with the pawn, and I'm currently better with these nice centrum pawns, with these nice three pawns at the center of the game. So the main move here is black usually takes the knight on c3, then I retake his knight, and takes. Then maybe I will develop my knight on f3. Yes, retake, just as I told you. Just as I told you, he takes my knight, I retake, and white has currently better position with this pawn center, with this center pawns. Now what? I think maybe c5 could be black's main idea, c5. So c5 is a normal move, if I know correctly. C5. We are waiting for C5. Okay. And what other kind of moves? She could have instead of C5. I really don't know, because the bishop, because this f8 bishop has almost no squares to put it. Maybe bishop to e7, probably. Bishop to e7, preparing kingside castle. Maybe. I don't know. So I definitely think that Orin is a bit stronger opponent than Risha. Apart from the fact that Orin has a slightly lower rating in the game than Risha has, and despite of this fact, I still think that Orin is a much stronger player than Risha in the vast majority of the cases. Okay, so now we are waiting, and please. If you like the video, please give us a thumb up and also subscribe. Okay, queen to h4, queen to h4. This is definitely not a good idea. He simply attacks my e4 pawn. Simply attacks my e4 pawn. So, for example, knight to f3 wouldn't be a great choice here, because if I go for knight to f3, then he takes my pawn clearly. So I somehow should protect my pawn. Maybe push it. Maybe some other things. So clearly f3 is not possible, because the black queens be because the black queen pins this f2, my f2 pawn. Let me think a little bit. Okay, he goes for his queen. He put his queen early in the game, which is not the best, not the best strategy in chess. So going out early with your queen is not a wise choice. Okay, I somehow have to protect my e4 pawn, and maybe bishop to the three. Maybe bishop to d3. Bishop to d3, then a knight to f3. Or maybe queen to c2. But I don't think that queen to c2 would be a great choice. Okay, let's go for bishop to d3, because with bishop to d3 I have control of the f5 square, and it looks like a great choice. Okay, go for bishop to d3. Bishop to d3. So after bishop to d3, my e4 pawn is protected. So I am planning now knight to f3. Yeah, and this is my first real appearance in the game in my channel. So now Risha is thinking, and he opted for bishop to d7. Okay. So it seems like to me that she's quite undecided. Okay, then I'm continue my developing. Okay. Okay, sometimes as an amateur it is very hard to speak and think at the same time. So that's why I'm sometimes in silence. Okay, so this black bishop don't have space. Queen to d3, castles f3, and then bishop to h3 is possible. No, because with this knight to f3 I'm attacking. So I really hope that after knight to f3, queen to g4, I won't receive checkmate. Okay, let's go for knight to f3, attacking the black queen. Hmm. Okay, flag 2. Knight to f3. Attacking black's queen. Yeah, just as I suspect, he opt for queen to g4. Or maybe that, or my plan would be castle, then knight to e5. And then I'm trying to change queens, and my knight is greatly looking on e5, attacking black bishop, this black bishop. So castle and knight to e5, maybe. Castle and knight to e5. My option here. And the black cannot attack my centrum pawn, so I think I already have a great position. Castle. I also have to be fast. Okay, let's do it. Castle. I really don't like to go for bishop to g5, but because after bishop to g5, black would simply continue with f6, and I have to retreat my c1 bishop, and this is not a great choice, so I would like to develop my bishop on a3. So first I go for a4, then I go for bishop to a3 maybe, because I don't think that I would have a great square for my c1 bishop somehow on the king side. Okay, so in this position, I'm definitely more developed than black. Yeah, and just as I suspected, he attacks this square. So the reason behind this bishop to d6 move is that she doesn't want that I go for knight to e5, because after knight to e5 queen takes rook takes, and And after the black bishop would take my knight, and I have to retake, and I will have this double pawns, which is not too good. Okay, so this bishop to d6 was a clever developing move. Okay, and so now I think I have to attack somehow this bishop, and I also would like to develop my c1 bishop to e3. So first, I go for a4, and after a4 I'm able to play bishop to e3, bishop to a3, attacking his bishop. Okay, black idea. I think black has this knight to c3 developing move. Of course, and I also have this e5 move. Okay. Okay. So Risha likes hanging her pants as she was described in her profile. Yes, knight to c6 is a normal developing move. Okay, let's play tricky. Let's play for tricks. So one trick should be herein is rook to e1, then after rook to e1 d5, and if he takes I retake on d5, and this is a check for the queen, and I won a knight. So I think rook to e1 is a very good move here. Rook to e1. And my knight is perfectly defending this h2 pawn. So I think I should go for rook to e1. But after rook to e1, I think black will castle short. So after rook to e1, black will castle short. If takes, yes. Okay, but I cannot find any better move. So I think rook to e1 is definitely better than bishop to e3. Here. Okay, rook to e1. Rook to e1. And another important thing that against Risha. So I think Risha is a bit weaker player than Orin. Risha. What? Knight takes to d4. Because this is a trick. So the main thing here that she doesn't have a checkmate if I retake with the knight. So the knight protects this h2 pawn. So retake bishop to b5, attacking my rook, bishop to d2, and okay. So I really don't like to retake with the knight because my knight protects the h2 pawn. So I take with the pawn. But this is. So this is a kind of move that against a computer, when a computer plays this kind of move, just as you saw earlier, just as you could saw earlier, what black plays earlier. So this is either a genius or a very stupid move. Okay, queen to h5 is definitely a move against my h2 pawn. So black is okay. So after for example, so black's idea could be here that after this move. After this move, I am trying to exchange queens, and after exchanging queens, I'm winning. So I think knight to e5 is the move here. Okay, and and you also could say that Risha is definitely not a too strong opponent indeed. And you are right. With this move, I'm totally agree with you. Here. If he takes with the bishop, I'm taking his queen. So that's the trick. Knight to e5. If the queen moves, then I go simply h3. Knight to okay, so knight to e5, and now her queen is attacked by my queen, so she has to move with her queen. And I really don't like that it is a safe move, because I will play g3. And Risha is not a too hard opponent. Yes, take. Okay, and now without queen, without the queen, black hasn't got any chances, because my knight is perfect here. Either with this double pawns. Yes. Okay, and this is nothing, because my pawn is protected. Okay, so I'm totally winning here. So without the queen, she is not threatening checkmate anymore. And I also don't mind if I have a double pawn on the e-file, because these double pawns are not isolated. Or I simply could take his bishop, and created a weakness as a form of double isolated pawns on the c-file. So knight to c6. Okay. Okay, and after this move, white is totally winning only in 50 moves. So I think just as I told you earlier, Orin is considered a much stronger opponent than Risha. Despite the fact that Risha has a slightly higher ratings than Orin has. So the main thing of deciding how strong a personality is in Chessmaster 11 is definitely not their ratings, because the ratings because most of the time the ratings of the computer players are not determining anything. So as you can see, it is move 15 and I'm already winning. So Risha is not a very strong player. So unfortunately, she is not a too challenging opponent. And she is sinking. Yeah. So, if I remember correctly, Randomless Chess or some kind of similar name, some player with the similar similar name wrote me that Orin is definitely not a too strong opponent, and yeah, he's right. Maybe. Okay, let's attack his bishop on a3. And now we exchange, and I am totally winning. So, yeah. So, Risha is not a very strong opponent indeed. And this is a nice Saturday evening. This is a nice Saturday evening. This is a good time to play chess. Yeah, I retake. And now white is already winning. The only thing I should be careful about is not to getting checkmate on the first row. So after I play f3 and defending this row, I'm okay. And my bishop also protect bishop and my rook also protects the b1 square. So for example, white has definitely two or maybe three good move. The first one is rook to b1. The second one is castle and rook f2 d8 is good for black. Okay, so now I go for this pawn is unprotected. If I go look to d1, check. So if I go rook to b1, rook to d4, rook a to b3, if he takes check and he will lose a rook. Okay, let's go for rook to b1. Okay. Rook to b1 is perfect move here. Okay, take. And then black should castle. And then black simply castle and that's it. Sorry, my nose is hurts. Sorry. Sorry guys, this is definitely not COVID. Okay, and I have a very easy win here. So guys, if you would like to play with me, I have an account on Chessbase. My Chessbase account is Unknown Chessmaster, and I also on chess.com. My account is Unknown Chessmaster 2 on chess.com. Okay. Here takes this. He's clever. He is clever. Okay. I still remain with my original plan. Yeah, I don't mind if he takes my pawn on d5 because, for example, c takes on d4, c is definitely a losing mistake because of Because of rook to b1 and I will, and I will win his her rook, and this is totally winning. So this is a huge blunder because of this, and I will stop this pawn on d3. So this is Risha is a very very weak player. Sorry for that match. I clearly don't I didn't suspect that she will play such a horrible move. Okay. So I'm planning for some kind of king walk, yeah. Yes. Okay, so these two pawns are getting a little bit dangerous for me. Okay. But my king is just in time. And her king is too far away. And then after this move, I will play. Yeah, this is nothing. Okay, let's target her her dangerous two pawns. And in this position, there is also no need to sacrifice my bishop, because if black plays c3, then I take her pawn on d3. Okay, takes. And this is nothing, and white is totally winning, because on the next move I will take his c4 pawn. Okay. So this is quite an easy game against Risha. So just as I told you earlier, and randomness rules, if I remember correctly, sorry if I misspelling your name. So randomness rules told me in a comment in my previous video that Orin is definitely not a too strong opponent. Dude, you are right, but within a specific group, Orin is considered to be a much more stronger opponent compared to, for example, Risha. So, for example, Risha has a slightly higher ratings than Orin have, Orin is a much more stronger opponent than Risha. Me too, king to c5, but then I have rook to b5, and okay, let's take. This is clearly winning for white from the move 25. So if you like this video, please give us a thumb up and also subscribe to my channel. And I am a Hungarian chess player with a rating of around 1200. Okay. Let's give here check, maybe a check. And if, for example, and if he go for a6, I have rook to c6, and I will take his pawn. So my rook will be in action, and so this is so Risha is considered a much weaker player than I expected. Yeah, and then I have this, and this is a game for me. Yeah, I know this. Okay, and his two pawns will die. Yeah, this is a check. Queen. This is a mate in 3, I think. Okay, so this is a mate. Guys, I'm really sorry for this really weak opponent. So Risha is considered to be a much weaker opponent than Orin was. Okay, thank you for watching and see you on the next video.